Welcome to my channel for Dandelions. My name is Mildred Lee and I have these two cases of liquid watercolor from Action, and it's set there for a couple of years. Here's all the other inks I have put here, so if in case I want to use it, I just take the whole case out. What I did previously, let me move it out of the way because I'm gonna grab this. This one I already did. You think, that's nothing. Yeah, that's right. So this is the new one, not used. This one I already did with tea. I used black tea and it was exquisite. When I dunked it in the water, I was like, oh, it looks like Coca-Cola and so dark. But that was in its wet condition. And once it dried, it looks like this. And I'm like, oh, nothing ever happened. So some of them already like, I don't know, this one is also good. Some of them were ripped because they were wet and they were stuck to each other. Oh, I don't have the ripped ones. I don't know whether. No, they were ripped, some of them. Maybe they were dried and then glued back to each other. That's a mystery. That's a mystery. So I'm going to put these things away. What I did was, in the afternoon, I already did the yellow ones. Then I did the orange ones. I did several. So I did like, first I did the entire doily, but not in the back. Only on top, because in the back mostly people, use glue and then put it on printed paper or envelopes. But this one had an accident. You see? This one also, because it was late with these on top. So it got a little bit smudged. These two got smudged. But it doesn't matter. If you put something in center, you mask it. So I had like different setups. So I'm not using my makeshift stand, I'm just using my hands. So what I did is I had several brushes, and I wetted the brush first, then I used the liquid watercolor, and I laid them all in a row, and I started to do first the uniform one and then only the edge, and then I thought by myself, okay, let's clean the brush real good. That piece of toilet paper I already threw it away. This is a second one, and I did the pink one. So now I'm gonna show you the pink one. I did the pink one first. Let me see. Oh wait, before I go to the pink, let me put that away. Okay, let me see. I must not make mess. So I need to put it carefully, all the things away. Because this is the bottom side of the A3 size cutting mat. And of course, I have already some. Oopsie. Underneath, so the reason, I now have another one there. Oh, two even. Okay, I hope I won't rip it. Come out. Oh, it got stuck. Oh, shoot. Okay, the other one, come on. Yes. So, as you can see, I have several ones. Let me see. Okay, so I believe I had one. No, I thought I had one in totally pink. But that's not the case. I cannot rely on my memory. I thought I had one that was totally pink. But because I did the yellow and the orange in total that particular color, I think I thought, I said to myself, maybe do some different kinds of, so they don't look the same. So, okay, these look the same. Okay, add these also on there. But I had these two, so I have three kinds here. It's the same doily, paper doily, but I used several kinds of approaches. And once they kind of dried, I've put them underneath this cutting mat, so it weighs it down, and then every paper will be flattened, because every paper that I had was like this, bulge up, so they were not totally flat. I just said to myself, try first stack of colored doilies to put it underneath, see how it really looks like. It looks good. So I'm really very, how do you say, pleased with these. And I had one that said it was pink, but it was not pink. You can see in this, this is actually the second batch. I did it like conservatively. And then I said to myself, oh, I need to be bolder, bigger. And that's why I did this third batch. And just did it like this. So I'm going to show you. Let me see. So let me see. Oops. I'm going to grab everything out so you can clearly see it. Okay. Right. So I started with a pink, but I said to myself, that's not pink. It looks like salmon. And then I started the next one in line, in the case. And it looks like a darker pink, but it actually was more pink. But it's watercolor, of course. So I said to myself, well, let's try differently. Just do it like here. Only the circles. The circle, the round inner thing. And I did. I did also another pink next to it. So you see different colors of pink here. But I did the one jar next to it. And it was quite dark. As you can see. It's darker pink. So I said to myself, okay, this one I did the inner circle. Let's do the center. So I did the center. So as you can see, I have different kinds. And then I did another one next to, that was this one, the other, the more right on the case. And that one was very dark pink. It was more like red. So I said to myself, let's do the inner smaller circles, so that's what I did. I did another one in a smaller circle and said to myself, maybe do the center also, so that's why you have different kinds. Then I said to myself, okay, I have done the red liquid watercolor, let's try the green bluish one. So I only used the light blue one. That's that I did light blue one, only the outer piece. And I said to myself, well, why not do the whole thing? So that's what I did. So everything I colored was only on the top part, not on the bottom. So as you can see, everything that's on the bottom is totally white. So I did not want to use the cutting mat to color it in. Wait, I need to grab it. So yesterday I was doing the video or the vlog, and I was in need of a new double-sided tape, and I used this lid to grab a doily and put it in here, and then lift it a bit off the mat, and then color it in. So when once I was done coloring, that's why I threw that piece away. I used the smudged up piece of toilet paper, and I cleaned it with a little bit of water. Now it's totally clean. So that's what I did. So I keep my cutting mat very clean. I don't know if it will stain my cutting mat. That's the reason why I put it on the lid of packaging, the clear transparent lid of the packaging. So I have here a lot of different kinds. So I have not used all these. I've only used the very light blue one. Yes, as you can see, there are different colors of green and blue. And I have done in the past, I didn't buy a lot of doilies then. As you can see, I have just this one and this one. Those are both white. And I had, like I said in the previous video, that was from a very, very long time ago, I used alcohol markers or twin markers or any markers, and just made a cutesy coloring. So instead of the liquid watercolor and brushes, I used, for that time, I used just markers to color those in. Not the center, the things on the sides, and some of them, I even draw some little things here to make it more cutesy. And yeah, that's it what I did. So this time I just tried a little bit differently, not to use markers, but the liquid watercolor. And yeah, it's just, in case, if you don't buy the colorful paper doilies, you can color it yourself. I think you can also do it with acrylic paint. I think you can use anything, I think, except the wax or oil. I don't know how to call these things, because these are so frail, this paper, so you can use those wax things. Or the oil, I don't know how to say it. It's just very round and very sturdy. And you do it like this, and then with your finger you can smudge it to make the color more pop. I don't know how to call these pencils. We call it in Dutch waskrijtjes. So I don't know how to say it in English. But everything that is liquidy, I think it's best to use that, because after some time they get dry. And then after they've dried, you need to press it down with something. So in this case, I try to use it with this cutting mat. And you can use, of course, a book. But they need to be dry. And then put stacks of books on top of each other, so each of them will be flattened more. Because now they look like a little bit scrunchy. I don't know how to say it. So it's better to flatten it, so it makes it more, you know, that finishing touch. As you can see, this is so flattened, and this one is also flattened. So I'm really happy that some of it I did flatten, but some of it I did not. Like this stack of failed with tea, black tea. That was really a fail. I don't know if you can do it with Fanta, cola, or whatever, and or ginger beer. I don't know if it, I don't think it's that good, because as you can see, I did this with black tea. So in wet condition, they look beautiful, but once they've dried, they don't look that good anymore. So I think stay out of the coffee, tea, and soda, and just use any medium that is really colorful. Like, I use watercolor, but you can use acrylic paint. You can use markers. So I advise you to use one of those three if you want to make your simple doily to pop, to have a pop of color. So that's it. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye, everyone.